Good morning, everybody. It's Brittany at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. And I felt like we haven't shown the back row of the sanctuary some love recently. Been running around with all the tiger boys. So we're gonna start with Nikita. I'm sure she looks beautiful on the camera right now. She's in a really good spot for the camera, which is at bigcatcams.com. There she is. So let's go back and say hi to her. She's still waiting on breakfast. Hi, lady. Hi. This is Nikita, our lioness. Hi, big girl. What you doing back here? We rubbins. Here, let me come around. Let me come around. Hi. Hi, big girl. Oh, where are we going? Hi. Get that ball out of your way. Get that ball out of your way so you can pass by. Is that what you're doing? So silly. I'm shocked you're not over there by your feeding walkout. So pretty. Yeah. Oh, now we're gonna lay down again. And lick my pole. We have no idea why she has this weird habit, but she does. See, it's okay to be a little weird. It's all right to be a little weird. Does everybody not have sound? Or is it just a few people? Yesterday, when I was at the Humane Society with the new Bobcat, I saw a lot of people saying they didn't have sound, but then a lot of people did, so let me know. Usually if you go out and come back in, that's... You are so silly. So silly. Okay, so Elizabeth has sound. Laurel has sound. Great. Yeah, so Romeo is our newest rehab bobcat. Yesterday he got an exam with Dr. Justin, and he's a very broken boy, but he did make it through the night. He's still eating well. I was watching the camera last night and this morning, and he's taking his meds and he's eating. He's not being super active, but that's kind of a good thing. Hi, lady. What are you doing? Get that ball out of your way. Whoa. Wow. Get that ball out of your way. Yeah. I know. You get it. Get that out of the way. Say move. Move. Thank you, Nikki, for the donation. And thanks to everybody who has sound. If you guys want to let other people know that don't seem to have sound, to close it and come back, maybe that'll work. I know. No idea why that's becoming an issue for people, but that's not fun. Hi. You gonna head over to where you eat? It's almost breakfast time. I think we got a little bit of a late start on feeding today with meds and lockouts and things like that. Oh, yep, heading to where the food is. What keeps me from wanting to reach out and touch them? I value having fingers and arms and hands. Oh, we're not gonna touch that ball, hopefully. All right, there we go. That's the one she's really protective over. No, it would be very disrespectful to touch these cats. They're wild animals with big teeth, and some of them have claws. Most of them Seems like we're badly declawed by previous owners, thinking that'd make them safer, but they're still very strong, she's showing you how her cage works. She can go from one section to another. She is heading to her roof section where her feeding lockout is. She's on now. Here we go. She's like, are you here yet? Knick-knack. No, Nikita's not lonely without a pride. You're right, lions do normally live in a pride. They're one of the only cats that does enjoy living around other cats. She was raised by people and was chained up in a basement. Was found during a drug raid. And so she did not grow up knowing how to be a lion. She's being awfully goofy this morning. Oh my. Digging at my tree. So she does not like other cats at all, which is why she is housed in an area where she can't really see any other cats and she's alone. Almost all other big cats are actually solitary by nature. They don't want to share space or compete for space or food or toys or any of that. It's a nice cool morning, so that usually makes the cats pretty frisky. Also, she's still waiting on breakfast, so that's also making her frisky. They did try to introduce her to other cats after she was confiscated in that drug raid. She went to the Tennessee Zoo, but quickly they realized she was not going to be able to. I mean, she didn't have claws. They declawed her, so unfortunately, there's no way she could defend herself. So she's very aggressive. But you're right, she was just scent marking her tree and she was scent marking her ball. Now she can hear the feeding cart, so that means breakfast is on its way. She's very aggressive with food. You guys might have seen Afton's video that she put out yesterday at bigcattv.com. Showed you quite a few of our most aggressive cats during breakfast time. So we don't loiter or linger. She is our only lion, but you might hear that rattling over there. That's the feeding cart coming. Before the feeding cart gets here, I'd like to show you Natalia if she's out. I nice you. Hi, babe. So this is Natalia. Hi, lady. Good morning. So we just got started. We just saw Nikita. I gave a little update about Romeo, our newest rehab bobcat. He's eating and taking meds and doing a lot of resting. Now we're here with Miss Natalia. Natalia is an Amur leopard. So she's a little bit fluffier than the huge. This is her best vantage point to see the feeding cart coming. Thank you guys that are posting links for me in the comments. Isn't she beautiful? I love her tail. Her tail, the end of her tail never stops moving. Isn't she beautiful?
You sure are pretty, lady.
Next, you can actually see Armani in the background. If you look right above Natalia's head, you see like a dark figure up on our platform. That's Armani.
Yeah, that's Miss Moni. It's your neighbor.
So beautiful. It's So when we walk over to Armani, you'll see the difference as far as the fluffiness.
You hear that cart? It's a breakfast cart.
She is very patient before breakfast. If you guys know her from other lives where I've shown her, you know that after breakfast she has a very specific routine where she walks and walks and walks and walks. She's got multiple bubbles. She actually is one of the largest enclosures here because we have so many different bubbles connected for her, but she just walks and walks and walks.
You gotta keep that girly figure. Yeah, you do. You are a wild one, lady. All right, let's go see your neighbor. Let's go see that neighbor. Thank you, Anna, for the donation. So we're gonna walk around Natalia's enclosure here. Front part of it. And see Miss Manny. Hi, lady.
Wow. Wow. Hi, babe.
Yeah. You've been having fun since you came home, huh?
So you know that last week we moved a lot of cats to and from our large vacation rotation areas. And Armani came home so that Shiloh Bobcat could go out for the first time.
Hi. You're very excited.
So this is her feeding lock out here for anyone who's brand new to us. And so you can see that the door is down. There's a plate in there. That's where the guys will put the food this morning, and then they'll lift the door. Way it's safe for her and safe for us.
Are you excited?
Wow.
Very exciting.
Matt, I plan to walk down to Jinx so you guys can see him, but he's doing well. He had to be on some antibiotics and pain meds for a little while, but he's been a good patient as well, taking his meds. Barbara, I am sort of working with the new Bobcat. I am a rehab team member, but I have not gotten my rabies vaccine yet. And actually, ironically, my first appointment for that is today. And so while he's on his 2-week quarantine, I am not able to care for him because I won't be done with the series before then. But moving forward, I should be able to work with all of them as they come in. But he was my first rescue that I went on where we actually needed to like search, find, and capture. So that was pretty amazing. Jill, I'm hoping to also show you guys Shiloh. My plan today was to show this whole back row area. So Nikita, we've seen Natalia, we're here with Armani. We'll go over to Manny, Jinx, and Shiloh on Funcation. And then I'd like to end with Aries and Orion.
So she is ready. Very, very ready.
But I am watching the new rehab Bobcat on the camera like a hawk. Because I am observing how Jamie and Lauren, so far, we each have a day. And then, like myself, Devin, and Abby are not currently vaccinated. So we can't care for them during their quarantine time. And so, since I'm going to get my vaccines, I've just been watching how they do everything. It has definitely been a very hectic, busy, crazy, like whirlwind 2 weeks. This month has been weird for me. It has felt like it's been the longest month ever, but it also is like, holy crap, it's already the end of January. So it's crazy. Here's Manny up here. Manny's our only Jaguar. I believe for the rabies vaccine, I need to do 3 different sessions. I don't know if it's a week apart or 2 weeks apart. I gotta figure all that out today.
Hi, mister. What are you doing? Hey, wait, come back.
He's like, oh, you are not the one with the food.
You're not the food lady today. Mister. Mister. Oh, you are doing this on purpose. You better come say hi. You better come say hi to me. He's like, you don't have the food. I'm not talking to you. I'm on a mission.
Manny is extremely food motivated.
Are you being so sneaky? Yes, you are. Are you grunting?
You're something. Do you see that? He snubbed me, you're right, Jessica. Only so he could make me think he wasn't gonna run and attack me. So goofy. So Manny and Natalia actually came to us on the same rescue. And I see everybody's been posting their bio links, so you can learn all about them and where they came from and how they came to be here. Find out their ages. Hi. We also, on our website, we have a lot of pages that give you a lot of cat facts. I see somebody just asked the difference between a leopard and a jaguar. Aside from region, to me, it's pretty obvious when you look at them visually. Manny's got a shorter tail, very sleek coat, bigger spots within spots. And he's got huge feet and a huge head. He's very stocky. You are something. You are something. He's stalking the golf cart. Anytime we bring in a new bobcat, a native wild bobcat that we do for our rehab and release program, we have to always assume that they have basically every disease and parasite. So we take every precaution, and that's why they have a quarantine period, and that's why we only have vaccinated keepers work with them in the beginning.
He's on a mission, isn't he?
The same 2 keepers that are feeding Nikki and Armani and Natalia, they also feed Manny. So he sees them. They're in sight. They are in sight. Glad you guys got to hear him grumble. It's always fun. Let's walk over and see what Jinx is doing.
Flat cat. Hi, Jinx. I see you already got food.
Jinx is on center route, so he's already gotten breakfast. Do you see that dark shadow?
That's Jinx. Hi, mister. I know I'm supposed to pretend I don't see you, but I see you. I see my cute boy. Hi. Jinx is a black leopard. You're so silly. Was that good breakfast? You cleaned your plate. You did. You cleaned it. Cleaned it right up.
You can see his spots on his face. He's got leopard spots, even though from a distance he looked solid black.
What are you doing? You being a very good boy? Yes, you're the best boy. Don't tell Cyrus I said that.
I call him best boy too. Of course I call Pharaoh that too, so.
All my boys.
Pretty amazing, isn't he? I was gonna plug our store today, bigcatrescue.biz. This morning I sent out our Valentine's Day mailer. So we are offering a discount code from now until February 4th for Valentine's discounts. I think it's like 10% off your whole purchase. Just gotta use the code WILDHEART20. And then it's buy one, get one free on all of our beaded bracelets. There's many of them that you can collect. And I think that code is STYLECAT20, but it'll be posted on our Facebook, and it went out in an email this morning.
Hi. What's that noise? You hear sirens?
There's some really cute downloadable Valentines that Jamie designed. They're really cute.
So handsome.
Follow him because I was gonna keep walking around the back area to Funcation so that we can see what Shiloh's doing.
Mister, where you going? Where are you going? I was hoping you'd go play with your ball because that is the best.
He loves playing with that big yellow ball in the morning. It's super cute. More grooming. Big cats have a routine. Very excited for breakfast. Eat a lot of food at breakfast, and then they sleep like all day long. But not after a very long grooming session.
Gonna get that ball or that donut?
No.
Just gonna prowl. Mister. So handsome.
Oh, he's just gonna go to his favorite napping spot.
Yep, you move slow, old man.
22 years old.
22-year-old.
My guess is he took some food up there at one point, and that's what he keeps smelling.
You're so silly. All right, we're gonna go see your neighbor. I'm glad that you're very up and moving. Very up and moving, aren't you, handsome?
Well, again, he's lived almost double what they would in the wild, so he's a very old cat. Times his age by 6, that's what he'd be considered in human years. And he definitely, because he was also declawed, you tend to see a lot of arthritis and issues with that, so. But he gets around pretty good. He's pretty playful, too, for his age. I know as soon as we walk away, he's gonna play with that yellow ball.
I know you too well, sir.
Just gotta go check out that food cart sound. All right, let's keep moving. I promised you guys we'd see 3 more cats, so we gotta do that because I have a staff meeting to get to. So we gotta walk all the way around.
Shiloh.
I know he's been preferring to get you. I can't blame him. The small cats really like this smaller roofed area back here, and it has smaller lockouts versus going up front to the huge lockouts that were made.
Hi!
For the cougars and leopards.
Hey, what are you doing, sir? Mr. Shiloh. Mr. Shiloh. Hi. Are you still waiting on breakfast? No, I think they're coming to check your plate. You already ate.
I know, I didn't bring any more treats, babe.
I didn't bring any more treats, I'm sorry.
You're gonna make my stabilizer crash. Yeah. You're gonna make my stabilizer crash. Will say it's one of the saddest things about captive wildcats is that they've got a lot of energy and they'd be used to roaming hundreds of square miles a day. So after they eat breakfast, they get pacey or give a lot of enrichment to help with that as well.
Just getting the steps in.
I think he's like, if I keep walking past this, a door will open up. Isn't he cute? I feel like the bobcats tend to probably explore Funcation like way more when it's dark and people aren't here. Because he has all of this space out here. So much space. 22,000 square feet. So, yes, Aries and Orion. That's where we're gonna go to next. It looks like Master Keeper Sue is most likely trying to get Orion to eat. For about the last 2.5 weeks, Orion has gotten very picky with eating. That was long before Artemis. And Aries is doing fine as far as food. But Orion is pretty much causing us to have to come out several times a day to get his food and meds in him. You know, he was in the hospital recently and it looked like some chronic kidney disease.
Hi, Rai Rai. I'm gonna eat, sir.
So he's been not really wanting to eat in the mornings, but by the evening he'll usually eat his full diet and his meds. So here's Orion. Orion and Aries are separated for feeding still because we don't want them to fight. And it's been tricky to know what Orion wants to eat. For me, the other night, he ate pork and turkey. But he is definitely pretty picky right now. So we'll walk around and see Aries, because I don't want to distract him if they're going to try to feed him. But so far, personality-wise, neither of them have changed too much. They're still together. The boys are still together. And they were always very, very bonded to each other. Let's see if we can find an Aries. Might already be in a den. Oh, no, back here.
Hi, mister. I had a feeling you were hanging out back here.
So the thing we have to remember about these guys is that, unlike all of the captive bred cats that we always see, these guys were born in the wild, so they do have wild genetics. 14's very old for them.
Hi, mister. Oh, this is Aries. He's longingly staring at Funcation. Hi, mister. Yeah. Are you being a good boy?
He's laying in the tunnel that connects their bubbles together. Not really a great angle. So this is Aries Cougar.
Best purr in the world, sir. Yeah. You keeping Orion snuggly and warm?
Actually did meds and fed Orion the night after we lost Artemis, and he was actually, that night, he was pretty eager for food, which was good. I got all the meds in him and about 2 pounds of food that night. But we know that his kidney values were a little alarming, and we'd been giving him fluids. And all the cats seem to get picky the older they get, so that's not super uncommon. Oh, I thought Sue... Okay, there we go. I was like, I thought Sue had left from Orion. I didn't want to interrupt her. But I do want you guys to see him. He got all cozy on his platform.
Hi, mister.
Let's go around this way. Maybe we'll see his face a little better.
Hi.
So there's Orion. As soon as the cleaners come out, they'll get put back together.
Mister. Hey, sweet boy.
No, Aries is the only one that has sort of a speckled nose. Artemis and Orion did not. His is more pink. Well, thank you guys so much to the people that donated today and everybody who shared this. Everybody who's going to shop for their Valentines this year at bigcatrescue.biz.
Hi, Orion!
I know that Orion has a Valentine this year on there.
Mister. Yeah. I'm gonna have to eat this afternoon, okay?
If you ever miss any of our videos or you like watching these live walkabouts or any of our medical updates, you can get lost for days upon days if you go to dailybigcat.com. Almost all of our vet procedures are done on live video. I do at least 4 walkabouts a week typically, and then more so if something special's going on. So you can find the Q&A with Brittany playlist. And today we saw the entire back half of the sanctuary from Nikita all the way over to Ares and Orion. That's Armani sawing over there. And thank you guys, everybody who has reached out to us about Artemis. We get spoiled here. You know, 14 is actually very, very old for these cats, but to us, doesn't feel like it, so. All right, well, you guys can rewatch this as soon as I hit finish, or go to dailybigcat.com and find it over there. Thank you guys so much. I hope you have a great day.